First Nation, and I do very much feel at home here, and not just because I was born at the Prince George Hospital, but I just feel like we're just family here today. That's because, oh, most of my family is here today. My mama, Susie George Schaefer, a lot of you know her from the Christian Life Center. She volunteered there for about 17 years. And my Auntie Agnes Sutherland from Nottingham, one of our beautiful elders, is here tonight. Also, my Uncle Johnny George is here. And also another wonderful elder from Nottingham. And my Auntie Irene George is here. She's a teacher in Fort Fraser, and her awesome grandson, Zaya. And my very handsome brother, Paul, and he's here and with the most beautiful girl in the world, Cheyenne Schaefer, who is my little niece. And you heard her there. That was her. She's really cute. She came up to me and she said, "I wrote a song, Auntie Cheryl." Isn't that cute? So anyway, I had to honor my family, Nottingham, and just say hello. We are very honored to be here this evening with you guys, and to be able to speak after the two grand chiefs, Linda Prince, who is our grand chief of the Carrier Nation for many years, and still we honor her as that, and Kenny Blacksmith, both of them are dear friends of mine, and we've gotten to sing and speak together in many different arenas, and I'm so happy that we were able to hear from her tonight. She is one of my heroes. I've known her pretty much all my life, and she spoke so eloquently. She always does, bringing together being a chief and also just the power of the Holy Spirit together beautifully. And also, Kenny, it's good to hear from these two, and to follow, and also to have Bernadine praying and Annette's beautiful prayers. I would like to also just acknowledge any chiefs that are here. Do we have any chiefs, or hereditary chiefs? If you could please stand just for a moment. I just would like to say, guys, our dear Bernice, thank you. So, Beatrice, and also the pastors that are here. We have a pastor of a church. Can you please stand up? Pastor, ministers, please stand up. We want to say thank you for coming. Randy, were we in last Thursday? We were in Nubik. So that's how pretty wild our schedule can be. And in a few days from now, we'll be in Ketchikan, Alaska. So it's pretty wild. But the Lord just is taking us all over the place. Our heart is, as Maria said, to share the beautiful story of Jesus with our First Nations people. Because when the gospel was brought to our native people, it was not given as the gift that it should have been, but rather it was used as a tool or a weapon of assimilation, as you've heard. And so many of our native people today don't want to hear about Jesus, and yet this is the most beautiful story that has ever been known to man, that Creator would send his son, Jesus, that he would live among us and feel our pain and know our hurts and learn our language and learn our ways, that he would die upon a cross, that he would give his life to free us from our sins and from all of the burdens, to heal us from all of our pain. And not only that, but that he would rise again so that we too might live, and that we live in the power of that resurrection. That is a great story. So I like to call myself a great storyteller. That's what I get to do. We travel and we tell our precious First Nations people about this beautiful story. And this song we're going to sing next is called Yeshua. This is the name that Jesus would have heard in his own ear as he walked on this earth. And it's based on John 14:6, where Jesus says to us very strongly, "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to Creator except through me." Without the way, we cannot be.